addition and subtraction. Friends, you know of 1, 2, 3, 4. You know these numbers as natural numbers. We will start from them and then learn about integer numbers and mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of them. You know that the sum of natural numbers is a natural number. For example, if I have 4 beads and I get 2 more beads, then there will be totally 6 beads with me. We show this as 4 plus 2 equal to 6. Similarly, let us see subtraction. If I give 2 beads from the 4 beads I have to my friend, then I will have only 2 beads left with me. We show this as 4 minus 2 equal to 2. So the answer comes again as a natural number. Will this always happen? If I give less beads than the beads I have, then the answer will always be a natural number. But if I give all the 4 beads that I have to my friend, then there will be no bead left with me. So we say that I have 0 beads left with me and show this as 4 minus 4 equal to 0. Please understand that this answer that we have got, that is 0, is however not a natural number. We will take another example. Today, in the drawing class in school, we were asked to get drawing papers. While going to the school, I bought 2 drawing papers from this shop near the school. The shopkeeper uncle told me that the price of 1 drawing paper was 3 rupees, so 2 drawing papers costed 6 rupees. But while coming from home, I had got only 5 rupees. When I told this to shopkeeper uncle, he said that it was okay and that I could pay him the remaining money the next day. The price of the drawing papers was 6 rupees and I had only 5 rupees, which means I had with me 6 minus 5 equal to 1 rupee less, which I would give the next day. This means that I did not have money remaining with me and I had a debt of 1 rupees. We show this as minus 1 rupees, money with me. If I have only 5 rupees with me and I have to spend 6 rupees, then we say that I have still to pay 1 rupee and show it like 5 minus 6 equal to minus 1. Now try and understand that minus 1 is also not a natural number. Similarly, if I have to pay 2, 3 or 4 rupees, then we can show minus 2 as minus 2 and similarly minus 3, minus 4, which means that for the amount of money that I have to pay, we show the minus sign and say that the amount of money is with me. Now we have 1, 2, 3, 4 as natural numbers and also 0 and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 numbers. All these numbers are called integer numbers. Among them, 1, 2, 3, 4 are called positive integers and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 are called negative integers. We have seen that the sum of natural numbers is again a natural number, but their subtraction is an integer. Now let us do this for integers. First of all, understand that if the integer numbers which we have to add are natural numbers, then their addition will give natural number, that is integer. But if one is positive integer and another is a negative integer and they have to be added, then what will happen? Let us take an example to understand this. Suppose I have 4 rupees and I have minus 2 rupees, that is, I have to pay 2 rupees to someone. Then how many rupees do I have? After giving 2 rupees out of 4 rupees, I will have 2 rupees left. So we can write this as 4 plus minus 2 equal to 2. So I have 2 rupees with me, which is an integer. Now, if I have 4 rupees with me and if I get minus 7 rupees, that is, I have to pay 7 rupees, then how many rupees do I have? We write this as 4 plus minus 7 equal to minus 3. That is, we say that I have minus 3 rupees, which means that I have a debt of 3 rupees. Understand that this time also the answer is an integer. Now, if I have to add two negative integers, suppose that I have minus 3 rupees and minus 5 rupees, then how many rupees do I totally have? This means that I owe 5 rupees to someone and owe 3 rupees to some other person. So, how many rupees do I have totally? We write this as minus 3 plus minus 5 equal to minus 8. And so, I owe 8 rupees totally, or we say that I have minus 8 rupees. This time also the answer is again an integer. This means that if we add a positive or negative integer with another positive or negative integer, then we have understood that the answer that we get is always an integer. Now, if we add a zero with an integer, then tell me what will happen. Isn't this quite easy? If I had some rupees with me earlier and if I get 0 rupees, which means I didn't get anything, that means that I will have the same amount of rupees as I had previously. So, we have understood that if we add 0 to any integer, then we get the same integer back. When we see all these things together, we will realize that the sum of any two integers will always be integers. Great! This is similar to what happened to the natural numbers when added, which also result in natural numbers again. Now, let us see what we can say about the subtraction of two integers. If we take both the integers as positive integers for subtraction, that is, if we take natural numbers, then the answer of subtraction will be an integer as we have made integers in that way. Now, if we have to subtract negative integers from positive integers, what will happen? Let us see an example. Suppose I have 6 sweets with me. I am going to give my friend minus 4 sweets. Then how many sweets remain with me? First of all, let us see what minus 4 sweets means. When I give minus 4 sweets to my friend, he will have minus 4 sweets. But this means that he will give me 4 sweets. That means when I say that I gave minus 4 sweets to my friend, then it actually means he only gave me 4 sweets. So, I will have 10 sweets left with me. We write this as 6 minus minus 4 equal to 10. That is, 6 minus minus 4 equal to 6 plus 4. Now, we will see what happens when positive integer is subtracted from negative integer. If I have minus 5 rupees and I am going to give 7 rupees to my friend, what will happen? I have minus 5 rupees means that I owe 5 rupees and I will be giving 7 rupees to my friend, means that I now owe 5 as well as 7 rupees. So, totally 12 rupees. So, now I have minus 12 rupees with me. We write this as minus 5 minus 7 equal to minus 12. From the above examples, we have understood that if positive integer is subtracted from negative integer or negative integer from positive integer, then the answer is always an integer. Now, only subtraction of negative integers remains. Let us see this also with an example. If I have minus 3 rupees and I am going to give minus 6 rupees to my friend, then how many rupees will remain with me? I will give minus 6 rupees to my friend means that he will give me 6 rupees. Earlier, I had minus 3 rupees, so I owe 3 rupees. To this, I added the 6 rupees given by my friend. So, I will have 3 rupees remaining with me. We write this as minus 3 minus minus 6 equal to 3. That is, minus 3 minus minus 6 equal to minus 3 plus 6. Now, 2, the answer is an integer. So, we can say that the subtraction of any two integers is also an integer. So, from this, we can understand that the subtraction of two natural numbers may not be a natural number. However, the subtraction of two natural numbers comes as an integer. These natural numbers, 0 and negative numbers, which were obtained from subtraction of each natural number from 0, all these are integer numbers. we have understood the rules of addition and subtraction of positive and negative integers also while doing all of this. In the next part, we will see the multiplication and division of integers and their relation with addition and subtraction.